Alright, hey VC, I'm Jamie. Welcome back. We are back with another video. Back this time with a vinyl thread. This one was started by Mike at PC31, the Vinyl Policeman. Love the title of Mike's YouTube channel and really enjoy his channel. If you are not subscribed to Mike, and Mike is based in the UK, I strongly urge you to do so. He's got an incredible vinyl collection, great knowledge of music. He does unboxings and a great, great channel and great presentation. So Mike, shout out for you and your channel for sure. Okay, so Mike's idea for a vinyl thread is show five albums from five artists on the same label, on one label. So five albums, five artists on one label. So I'm going to pick a Canadian label, True North Records, which is certainly always been one of my favorite record labels in terms of Canadian labels. There's many to choose from, but True North really, for me, comes to mind. A great label that focuses or spotlights on folk artists, blues artists, country artists, that sort of thing. That's kind of the mainstay. They also do feature international artists, but I'm going to spotlight on the Canadian artists on True North Records. True North Records, largely an independent Canadian label, although it had major distribution, created in 1969 by Bernie Finkelstein. And Bernie has won so many great Canadian music awards over the years. He's managed a number of different acts, including the first artist I'm going to show you. But True North Records, again, when the idea of starting any kind of independent Canadian record label is always a tough going, no matter when. But certainly in 1969, that would have been a tough going, haul, but made it work and is a terrific record label, True North Records. So I'm going to start off with the artist most associated with that label, of course, the artist Bruce Cockburn. This is his album Stealing Fire, and this from 1984. Bruce Cockburn's had a very long career, started off very much as acoustic solo kind of folk artist, and then kind of gravitated more to sort of folk rock, that sort of thing. He's got a ton of albums to choose from. This is be a nice place to start if you're really not familiar with Bruce Cockburn. He takes on a lot of sort of world music or world politics, if you will. Lovers in a Dangerous Time is featured on this one, and Bare Naked Ladies did a cover of that song, also featured on here. If I Had a Rocket Launcher, Peggy's Kitchen Wall, just a terrific album. So if you're, again, he's got so many records, so if you're looking for a place to start with Bruce Cockburn, I would recommend this album, and then of course this on these quite simple but great True North labels. So you can kind of see that there. All right, so Bruce Cockburn. Next, we're going to switch gears. Not just a sort of folk or country based label, but they also had Rough Trade, the band. I've been chatting about this on my last video. I picked up a Best of Rough Trade. Rough Trade, kind of risque subject matter in terms of songs that they had on the radio at the time, kind of raised some eyebrows. Songs like High School Confidential and Fashion Victim. They came from sort of, I don't want to say music hall, but almost kind of a theater cabaret kind of background, and featuring Carol Pope on vocals and Kevin Staples. So this is actually autographed by Carol Pope, and I've seen Rough Trade and both Carol Pope solo performing a couple of times in Stratford. A quick story for you. Last time Carol Pope was in town, this was before COVID. It was a solo sort of acoustic kind of thing. She had two acoustic guitar players with her and was doing some of her solo stuff, some Rough Trade stuff, and then requested if anybody in the audience one to hear song. So a lot of people were requesting the song Fashion Victim from this album, and then she was kind of, well, I don't have the words and whatnot, and you know, kind of making excuses not to play it, which is odd if you're going to take requests and then say you're not going to play the song. But then I was thinking, well, wait a minute, she autographed this album earlier in the concert, and on the inner sleeve is the lyrics to all of the songs, of course, including Fashion Victim. So I thought, well, so I took the record out of its sleeve, and again, True North, the label. So I took the record out of its sleeve and went up to the front and then just gave her the liner sleeve and said, here you go. And then she was kind of, shall we say, in a position where she pretty much had to do it. So she got her glasses out, and the band was able to work up the song. And so she did the song Fashion Victim. But then towards the end of the song, she did this dramatic where she's, you know, singing the song, reading it. This is like one of the encores. It's towards the end of the show. And then she just flings the liner or the sleeve away, and I was just, what are you doing? That's my record sleeve. So thankfully, I was able to get it back intact. Nobody stepped on it or it didn't rip or anything, but I couldn't believe she did that. But it was kind of a dramatic flair, shall we say. So, okay, there you go, rough trade. And in terms of the Canadian records, I would say this, you know, if you like Canadian music, this is essential for anyone's collection. 1980, this came out. Okay, again, switching gears, how about Murray McLaughlin? And this is quite simply Murray McLaughlin's greatest hits. Murray McLaughlin, a similar artist to Bruce Coburn, Murray McLaughlin does a little bit more country, folk, with also, he does have a love of standards as well. But he has the song Farmer Song, is pretty much his most noted song, a nice ode to farmers and rural way of life. He's got a very distinctive voice. On the Boulevard's also a great tune, Down by the Henry Moore. So this is quite simply Murray McLaughlin's greatest hits. He's, again, very much like Bruce Coburn. He has a number of albums, quite a long career, and of course on the True North label. There we go. Okay, so the next two have to be on CD, I am afraid. My apologies on that, but we have the artist Colin Linden, a grossly underrated artist. Colin Linden, a great singer-songwriter, great guitarist, much more the blues side of sort of that kind of a folky thing going on. He is kind of the go-to session player. He's worked with Bruce Coburn, of course, label mates, and he's also worked with Colin James extensively, but a terrific artist. And so this is his album, Easing Back to Tennessee. Again, kind of an acoustic thing going on, but this, in fact, yes, as you might be able to see just down there, it is, of course, on the True North label. And another artist that, or another group, I should say, that certainly is well-loved, Blackie and the Rodeo Kings. So this is their album, High or Hurtin'. And Blackie and the Rodeo Kings is kind of a sort of a Canadian supergroup that features Stephen Fearing. And again, kind of rockin' country, if you will. They do have a number of albums out over the years. There you go. And yes, Colin Linden, of course, featured with this band as well. And I don't have enough Blackie and the Rodeo Kings. Again, they do have a number of albums out. They always put on an amazing concert. I haven't seen Blackie and the Rodeo Kings, but I've seen Colin Linden and Stephen Fearing. But this, in fact, yes, on the True North label. And unfortunately, it hasn't got the traditional arrow, but it is, in fact, I think it's on the back there. There we go, True North label. And then you can see just that label there. Okay, so that is just a spotlight on some of the artists available on the True North Records. And again, thanks to Mike at PC31 Vinyl Policeman. Great YouTube channel. I will leave a link to his channel below. So again, do take care. Hopefully everybody's staying cool out there as best you can. We'll chat again soon. Bye-bye.